Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli as the teacher, and today we are going to make this. This is a very short tutorial, so I will quickly tell you how to create this effect. So open a new file, click Black Presentation, collapse the thumbnail view. And if you want the guides to appear, then go to the View menu and then click Guides. So you may align the objects properly in the middle of the slide. Go to the Home tab and then change the layout to Plan. And this is one of my favorite layout. Now go to the Insert tab, click the Shape drop-down menu, and I will draw a rectangle. Align the rectangle to the center and the middle of the slide. Remove the fill color and change the outline weight. And I would like to apply a white background color to the outline. But before that, I will change the background color of the slide. Let's say to black. Now select the rectangle and change the outline color to white. Now copy this subject and paste on top of the previous one. Align it to the center and middle of the slide. Zoom a little bit and then increase the size of the second rectangle by holding the Ctrl, Alt and Shift keys while resizing the rectangle. So the size may increase from all the sides simultaneously. Now repeat the same steps to create more rectangles. It is up to you that how much rectangles you want in your presentation. I will go with around 15 rectangles. You can either align using the align commands, or you can drag and drop the rectangles over the previous one. It's up to you. As you might also know that you can repeat the last command by pressing the F4 key, but that is not going to work on. But that is not going to work while copying and pasting the objects and while increasing the size at the same time. So you have to do this manually. Three more rectangles I will draw. Maybe that are enough for now. Okay, now the animation is very simple. Select all these objects, go to the animation tab. Click the Add Animation drop down button and then click Spin. Set the start type to with previous. Open Animation tab. Set a duration of around 0.25 seconds. Open the effect options while selecting all the animations in the list. And I will rotate them to around 20 degrees. And will also apply auto reverse. That's it, and hit the OK button. So all the rectangles are spinning simultaneously. So I will add a delay between each animation. I think I should go with 30 degrees instead. That will be fine. So I am going to add a delay for around 0.05 seconds, 0.10 for the third one, 0.15 for the fourth one, and so on. So let's play all of them. That's nice. You can also add one more effect to this animation, and that is select all these animation, go to the animation tab, click the add animation drop down button, and then apply line color emphasis effect. Set it to play with previous. Set a duration of around 0.25 seconds. Go to the effect options and change the colors as you like and apply auto reverse. That's it. Okay. And same way, add a delay. As you can see that it has added a delay of 0.65 seconds to all the line color emphasis effect. But I want all these line color animation to play from the beginning, so I will remove the delay and then open the effect options. Make sure auto reverse is on and choose the colors as you want. Hit the OK button, and then same way add delay to the line color, that is 0.05 for the second, 0.10 for the third, 0.15 for the fourth, and so on. This is a very short animation, so I will also tell you one more thing. If you find that my English accent is good enough to understand what I am teaching you, then let me know in the comment section. Then I will try to upload some more good few tutorials about PowerPoint. Will be 55, 0.60 and 0.65. Let's see. Okay, this is a very short animation, and I would like to repeat this a few more times. So you have two options for that. You can either create more duplicate slides as many times you want the animation length, like I am adding 5 slides, and each slide has a maximum animation length of around 1.2 seconds. So that will be around 5.10 seconds total animation. And finally, select all these slides by holding the shift key. Go to the transition tab, uncheck on mouse click, and make a check mark on after, and set a timing of 1.2 seconds. If you want to add a little bit delay before the second animation start, then you can increase the timing here to around 1.5. So after completing the one cycle, it will stop for around 0.30 seconds. Let's see. I hope you will like this tutorial. If you find it useful, then please drop a like and leave your valuable comments in the section below. And if you find it interesting, then you can also share it with your friends. And thanks for watching, and I will meet you in the next tutorial. Bye for now. Take care.